When you're screaming now, but you can't make a sound, you know it's only a dream. When your back hits the ground and things turn around, you know it was only a dream.
Taylor, I've known that I've wanted to spend the rest of my life with you since the day we met. And as we stand here before some of the most important people in our lives, I can't believe the day has come where I can finally marry my best friend. I'm writing my vows, trying to put into words the way that you make me feel, but you know it's hard for me. When I think about you, I get distracted by the beautiful smile and your adorable laugh. Do you know when you see a breathtaking sunset? One of those ones that you just never comes out the way it looks in the camera. You know, that's sort of how it feels right now. Somehow I can go on and on about how you are the most amazing person I have ever known. And for your kindness, your strength inspires me every day to be the best man I can be. Not only for myself, but for our son and our family. But it doesn't feel like it will ever be enough to properly convey how my heart wants to beat out of my chest every time I look at you and how this every single and how this is the single most confident decision I will ever have to make in my entire life. You are the foundation on which I want to build my future. From the days where I felt like we had nothing, I knew I had you. But now it feels like that we're living that one Drake song. Started from the bottom, now we're here in Mexico. We have our jobs, our dogs, a car, a home, a son, and a family. And we did it all while we're weird and goofy and laughing the whole day. I would not trade this for anything because I truly feel like the luckiest man alive. So now for my vows. I promise to always see you with the same eyes and the same heart that I see you with at this exact moment. I vow to honor you and respect you, support you and encourage you. I promise to dream with you, celebrate with you, and walk beside you through whatever life brings. I vow to laugh with you and comfort you during times of joy and times of sorrow. And I promise to always pursue to fight for you and love you unconditionally and open-heartedly for the rest of my life. The road to get here wasn't always easy, but it was absolutely worth it. And I promise I would always choose to walk it with you, this timeline and every alternative one as well. I love you.
Will you stay here with me? Will you stay here with me?
Bubs. If you asked me to speak in front of all of our family and friends 6.5 years ago, you and I both know I wouldn't be able to say more than 2 words without passing out. The timid 19-year-old version of myself had no idea how much growth, security, and blessings would unfold over the next few years with you by my side. I've known from our very first date that you are the one that my soul has been longing for. And had I known what I known back then, I would have taken you up on all your date offers before I finally caved and said yes. That day marked the first of many instances where your perseverance and persistence overshadowed my anxiety and doubt. And I can't begin to count the amount of times that you've had to drag me out of my own darkness. But I'm eternally grateful. You've given me the space and confidence to grow into my true self and love me through my trials and tribulations. And your playful and innocent presence has healed my inner child. And you've given me grace when I least deserve it. From your I love you text at 1:43 to your winks across a crowded room to still acting surprised when all of my surprises are ruined. All the small moments remind me of how loved I truly am. You are my best friend, my lover, my adventure buddy, and my confidant. So when I say I do today, it means I will. It means I'll express my love for you in all of our day-to-day lives. I will never stop making us feel like our lives are the biggest adventure. I'll be your forever friend and your listening ear. I'll find reasons to celebrate life with you every day. And I will still love you even when you're old and wrinkly and still playing Call of Duties with the boys. And when our home fills with even more little feet and our time alone together feels far and few in between, I promise to find stillness in the chaos with you and cherish every fleeting moment with you as if it was our last. Standing before you today, I can't say that you're the man of my dreams, because you've been creator of all of my dreams. I love you times a million in every lifetime, and I'm so honored and proud to be your soon-to-be wife. Thank you.
You may kiss the bride.
I could fuck with you for infinity. Even if you please.
You home, you fit in right with the family. I can't imagine a time without you. You're pretty much the little brother that I've always wanted, even though we're only 1 month apart, but we'll take it. And to you, welcome to the family. I'm so glad you're marrying my brother over here. But no, I'm so happy that you found someone like Andrew. He's so perfect for you. I'm so happy to see you happy after everything that you've been through. It's just a very inspiring relationship to have seen and grow before our eyes, pretty much.
My sister, growing up, she used to say all the time, like, I am not gonna be a mom, I'm never gonna get married, love is not for me. And I am so happy that she was wrong, and I am surrounded by some of the greatest people that I have ever known. It's so hard to think about it and think about when exactly I stopped being an older brother and started being like a dad almost. It's so weird. It's like you get this feeling like a flip switches and you're like, oh my gosh, I'm all of a sudden concerned about what my sister's going to be doing with her future and, you know, who's going to be taking care of her and all this stuff. And I was just talking to Spencer right before this and, you know, I was telling him, like, I am so thankful that we're here right now. And he was like, oh, because, you know, it's wrapping up and your sister finally got somebody. I'm like, no, I'm happy that it was Andrew. You are literally the perfect person. When I think of somebody taking care of my sister and my nephew and the rest of the kids that you're going to be having in your future for the rest of your guys' lives, I am so happy, I'm so grateful, I'm so thankful that it's you that's going to be taking care of my sister.
Tay and Andrew, you guys are so special to me. Andrew, when you first started dating Tay, every time I saw you guys, Tay never wanted to say hi to me. I obviously didn't know she was just shy at the time. I just thought I like smelled bad or something. I was like, shit, am I one of those people? Am I one of those people? Like, stinky people. We eventually became really great friends after Andrew invited me to Tay's 21st birthday. That was such a great night. I've never seen someone actually go to the corner in a bush and throw up and then start dancing like no one was watching and then come right back and celebrate more. Literally, that was the moment that I knew Tay and I were gonna be close friends. We've shared so many beautiful moments together and laughs. Tay, you're the queen of cartoon references and I absolutely love that about you. Andrew is easily one of the funniest guys I've ever met, and I appreciate you so much more than you think. You're both truly an inspiration. Watching your relationship develop into what it is today is honestly one of the most beautiful things I've ever seen. You guys have set the bar too damn high. I feel like Leo has no idea how blessed he is to be part of such a loving and caring family, a family that has welcomed me with open arms, and I can never be so grateful.
Taylor and Drew have asked that I don't share any embarrassing stories or crude jokes and my best man speech. So that's going to be it for me tonight. Thanks for listening. All those who really know Taylor will then know she's a wonderful person who deserves a good husband. Thank God Drew married her before she found one. Taylor is someone that I've gotten to know over the years after Drew met her, and the way she has gone from this cute girl I kind of like to a best friend, a significant other, fiance, mother, shout out Leo, I know you're here, milk drunk already, told him take it easy, and then the one for Drew has something truly incredible to witness firsthand. I'm so happy for you and Drew that you found each other. Deserve nothing but the best of it. I like you, we should turn to each other. You are now looking into the eyes of the person who is statistically most likely to murder you. You can look that up. Get your phone out. That's actually true. I had to fact check that one. I'll end my speech here by proposing a toast to the happy couple. Raise your glass and join me in a toast to Drew and Taylor. May you always remember the love that brought you here today. I love y'all.
And I'm ready to party, baby, so I'm ready to party.